In this video, I will show you how I recreated this Photoshop artwork on a mobile app. Welcome back to a brand new episode where I recreate Photoshop artworks on IBIS Paint X. And in today's episode, we will be recreating this beautiful work done by Learning Screen. And by the way, if you want to download the stock images and watch the original Photoshop tutorial, then check the link in description. So with that being said, let's load IBIS Paint X. So here we are in IBIS Paint X, and I have opened our artwork on the side for reference. Let's start off by adding this beautiful image into the canvas. We only need those mountains that are far away, so I'm removing the sky. Since we removed the sky, let's replace it with this sky, and using the mesh form, I'm warping it a bit like this. We only need the sky, so I'm removing this bottom area. To fill the bottom portion, I duplicate the sky image and placed it on the bottom area and wrapped it a bit to get the continuity. Now, let's add this beautiful image. As always, we don't need the full area, so I'm removing the top. If we look here, we have these trees, so let's hide them by masking out a portion from the top area, and with the help of mesh form, let's get it in place. Now that's all done. I'm making a few color changes for the sky using color balance. Also some adjustments in brightness and contrast. Next, adding this planet, and let's keep it right here like this. I changed its blending mode to screen so that it blends in. Now, I know this all looks a bit weird, but trust me, it will look better. Let's add the globe. And I don't know why it looks weird. Maybe if we adjust the brightness and contrast a bit. Yes. Now that's perfect. Now let's continue with adding more glow. Now let's work on the foreground. Maybe we should flip it like this, and keep it here like this, and remove the unwanted area. Also, warp it a bit to get the shape right. Since one of the rocks is ready, let's add one of our characters. Yes, the boy. Let's keep him somewhere like this, and remove the unwanted area. I kept a few in the bottom area because it will be helpful to blend in. Let's hide this string by selecting the color from the side and painting on top, and continue this process until it's blended well. Now, let's paint highlights. So I painted highlights on both of them, so let's move on with adding in his wings, adjusting its brightness and contrast a bit. For the second wing, I duplicated and squeezed it like this. Now we need to blend them by adding shadows. Ooh. highlights on the top area because we got strong light source coming from backside. Now let's add these plants. Adjusting its brightness and contrast, adding more of them to fill the front area. I did the same in front area as well. Okay, so now we need to cut this out and I have no idea how to do it. Finally, I somehow managed to mask it out. I kept it in the front and blended it in there. Adding more highlights on them. So his wings are tied up with some ropes, and we need to cut out rope from this image. I'm hoping one rope would be enough, and we could just duplicate them and use it. Now let's wrap the ropes around in by using mesh form